Are you looking for advertising and marketing to enhance your tile business? Well, look no further. OMG National, the producers of Tile TV, have 20 plus years experience building marketing for growing tile companies. We started out in 1989 producing telephone on-hold messages. We now produce videos and build the industry's best websites, help you leverage social media. We even code and build effective mobile sites. So what are you waiting for? Image is everything. Finally, fully rested after 4 days of pounding the pavement of the show floor at Coverings, NTCA's Leslie Godden, editor for both Tile Letter and Tada magazines, provided Tile TV with a trove of trends emerged from the tile event at Atlanta's Georgia World Congress Center at the end of April. Here is the 411 on the new tile aesthetics. The prevalence of the ubiquitous rustic stone look from yesteryear has given way to the prominence of wood for aesthetics and practicality. Cozy underfloor heating doesn't pair well with the natural stuff. Nearly every booth presented its interpretation and treatment. Weathered, pickled, antiqued, hand-scraped, rustic, or a jumping-off point that's modernized with graphic treatments. Marazzi launched its Divine Woods decos and liners, while Vitromex launched the Madeira line. Another beautiful product was the Magnolia Wood Look 8x36 porcelain from Florida Tile. From the world of Spain comes leading manufacturer Tau, bringing a colorful spin to wood graphics with graffiti in 6x36 planks. Raw elegance from Hirsch Glass renders a wood look in glass plank. And the best of both worlds, digital print Piedra Terrazza with Madeira Sauna wood at Porcelaniti. Also at Coverings, stone isn't passé. In fact, inkjet technology is taking stone renditions to fantastic new heights. Vein-cut stone graphics prevailed in Atlanta, and many tile makers are combining attributes of several different natural stones into mythical hybrids that can only exist courtesy of the magic of tile technology. Yes, this is inkjet! At Graniti Fiandre, the precious stones collection in the Maximum Fiandre Extra Light line replicates the look of polished stones, some with quartz-like sparkles, and color and pattern movement in huge 5x10 panels with mineral glasses on top for depth and realism. Virtue, a pristine white marble-look porcelain from Crossville, brings elegant aesthetics and durable performance into reach, and Vane from Imola combines aesthetics of both wood and stone into one tile. Held for the first time in Atlanta, the show had a significant increase in attendance from the leading architects and designers, and they were treated to new product offerings from well-known designer Felipe Stark, who created his first tile collection from San Agostino with a textured and plain surface and faux grout joint in neutrals and brights. At Vallelunga, Giovanni Barbieri devised Memento, which offers a soft, smooth, worn, and tumbled stone look to field tiles and mosaics for walls and floors. At Interceramic, a Moods collection makes it easier for designers to match wall, floor tiles, and mosaics. Mix and match also refers to mixing and matching attributes of differing materials, such as concrete, glass, stone, and wood, for unique surfacing treatments. If you're into more of a classic look, beveled tile, like the Marazzi Oxford series, was a stunning new ceramic introduction. Other classic introductions included three-dimensional optical illusions and caustic or majolica looks, all being recreated through new tile technologies. An example comes from Aparici with the Moving series that combines black and white patterns with glam decos for an intriguing effect. The tile industry is known for technological advancements being launched at Coverings. This year, Hydrotect, an antimicrobial air-cleaning stain-fighting treatment by Toto, was shown at Crossville, the only U.S. producer to supply the technology, now in its fourth generation. Since it's applied in a second firing, it can be applied to any of the company's lines for residential, commercial, or indoor or outdoor applications. During a demonstration at Crossville's booth, a stain on a treated tile dissolved completely within 2 minutes. Castel Grande Padana also offered the technology in its bio self-cleaning ceramics. inkjet technology was everywhere, and Vitromex showed that it's beautiful on red body tile too, applying its graphics capability to create more fantastic looks at a more reasonable price for the builder market. The Orion series was also introduced at Coverings, perfect for the builder market. Perhaps the most significant introductions at Coverings were tiles in both large format and reduced thicknesses, or thin tiles. Many offerings of 24x24, 24x48, or larger 5x10 panels, such as Plain at Stone Peak, were unveiled. Plain is an engineered porcelain coming in different modular sizes, up to 5 feet by 10 feet, for interiors, exteriors, countertops, veneers, and much more. Size also continues to morph out of the square into a plethora of planks that show wood graphics to best effect and offer fresher formats for more traditional looks. More and more factories are offering reduced thickness, thin tile models. Leia showed a fabulous mural printed on its thin tile and noted that the factory can print any graphic desired, with quantitative as small as one piece. While Leventina's Teklim 3mm thin tile comes in 38x108 for walls and cladding. Finally, whether it's a subtle glint or a glimmer, golden threads, or a wash of bronze, platinum, silver, or gold, tile makers are incorporating metallic looks into their tile creations. Imago from La Fabrica combines traditional textile design, metallics, and stone influences. Arch Concept from Apavisa offers textural textile patterns in silver, gold, or bronze for walls. This is just a glimpse of all of the incredible product offerings on display at Coverings. Isn't it obvious? If you are a tile industry professional, you simply have to be at Coverings 2014, which will take place in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada, April 29th through May 2nd. Put it on your calendars now!